In this video, we're going to look at the topic of counting principles, and in particular, these two words here, combinations and permutations. So we'll have a quick look at how these types of questions appear in some common IB maths exam questions. Okay, so if I have an example, let's use three letters, A, B, and C. If I asked you how many ways could these three letters here, A, B, and C, be arranged? Well, A, B, C would be one. We could have A, C, B. And then if I started with B, I could have B, A, C. I could then have B, C, A. And then if I start with C, I'll have A, B, and C, B, A. So if we were to count these up, there would be six ways, and these are actually called permutations. So there would be six permutations here, permutations, to order these three letters in all of their different ways. Now, what a combination is a combination is the same as a permutation, except the order doesn't matter. So if I were to say to you, how many ways could you order A, B, C, but the order doesn't matter, well, there's only one way. It's just A, B, C. So A, B, C and A, C, B, these two here, these are two different permutations, but they're the same combination. So combination is where the order doesn't matter. Permutation is when the order does matter. So they are different. Now, what you may have learned is if you have three things like A, B, C, or three items, the number of permutations is just going to be 3 factorial. And 3 factorial is 3 with this exclamation mark, and this is just that number multiplied by all of the numbers below it. And 3 times 2 times 1 is equal to 6. So if you ever get any question, how do I order, or how many ways can I order 10 different things, it would just be 10 factorial. Or 4 different things, it would be 4 factorial, and you just work out how many that is. Now, what these questions then do is they get a little bit trickier, because they may say, okay, well, if I have, let's go back to my 3 original letters, and I'm going to add another letter, the letter D. And if the question said, well, how many ways could we write A, B, C, D, but we only want to choose 2 of them? So we could choose A, B, and then B, A, and then A, C, and then C, A, and then A, D, and then D, A. And you can realize it's going to be quite a lot. And this here is the same combination, but they're two different permutations. So that's the key point here. These would be the same combination, but they would be two different permutations. Now, luckily, we have formulas to work out how many there will be. There'll be more than just these ones here. There'll be heaps of them. And it's these formulas here. The combinations formula for this question would be how many combinations of 2 from 4 objects or 4 letters. So 4C2 would be how many combinations. And the formula for this is just this one up here. Now, you can see 4C2 written as 4C2 on top of each other. That's the same thing. This would just be this top number factorial over the bottom number factorial, and then the top number minus the bottom number factorial. So 4 minus 2 is 2 factorial. And you can use some algebra techniques to simplify these without a calculator. We can go 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And then you would have 2 times 1 for this 2 factorial, and 2 times 1, and these can cancel out, these ones here. And then the 4 can cancel out with a 2 to be a 2, and we'd get 6 over 1, which is 6. Now, this is different to 4P2, permutations. The formula is slightly different. There's no R factorial on the bottom line here. So it would just be 4 factorial over 2 factorial, which would be 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, over 2 times 1, therefore there will be 12. And hopefully that kind of makes sense here, because there would be 12 permutations for our example, but only 6 combinations, because this 2 becomes 1. These 2 permutations become 1 combination. Okay, so that's what these questions look like. They do get a little bit trickier when they might add multiple elements. They might say, well, if you have 10 options to choose from and you only want to choose 4, and then 8 options and you only want to choose 3, so there might be multiple events happening here. So you'll need to find each of the individual combinations and then maybe multiply them with each other to get the different events. But this is the basic idea. The goal of this video is just to quickly understand what the difference of a permutation and a combination is. You can solve these on your calculator. If you have one of these calculators here, it'll be in the calculator section where you can go to the probability and it would be permutations and combinations. So I'll just check our answers here. If we put 4, 2, that will be 6. And if we did permutations, 4, 2, this should be 12. It'll be 12. Okay, so I encourage you to practice these questions. The more you do, the more comfortable you are with this topic. So good luck.